Hi everybody, Hasan Sharik, Regulated Canadian Immigration Consultant, back with another video. Lovely Saturday morning. It's a little chilly now, but it's a nice sunshine. And there was an update just yesterday or a day ago. And I thought that I'll make a quick video and share that with you. So international students, a lot of international students have been stuck in this situation where some of them have already obtained the study permit, like those before 18th of March, and some are in the process, like they've submitted their applications, but there was a travel restriction. So students who obtained their study permit after March the 18th were absolutely not allowed to travel to Canada, whereas those who had it before March the 18th could travel if it was deemed necessary. So the new update that Government of Canada has provided is that starting from 20th of October, international students who've been granted a study permit, be it before 18th of March or afterwards, will be allowed to travel to Canada. The only condition that is there, that the institution that you're going to study at, which is the DLI, the Designated Learning Institution, that particular institution must have an approved plan with the relevant provincial or territorial government, like the province or territory where they're based in. So they must have their plan in terms of how they will handle the students who are coming in, what are the policies that they have in place to cope up with situations related to COVID and stuff. If they have an approved plan and it is there on the web link which is provided, what I'll do is that I'll provide that web link in the description of this video as well. So if your institution is part of that list and you have the study permit, you will be allowed to travel to Canada after 20th of October. Now, I know a lot of people will start asking details. In all honesty, this is all that has been informed by Government of Canada at this stage. More details will follow. Probably in a week's time, we'll have more clarity on that. And that's only when we can explain that to you guys as well. So no need to sort of jump on the bandwagon. Few things that if you are such an applicant that you are married and you have your spouse, common law partner or a dependent, they can travel with you as well. So this exemption will be for spouse, common law partners as well. In case of applicants who are under 18 and they have their parents or legal guardians who would want to travel in the first instance to help their children sort of settle in, they will be allowed as well, but not anybody else. So these are the updates in terms of international students being allowed to travel to Canada starting from 20th of October. Great news, because I know that a lot of applicants who've applied for study and some have been granted their study permits, some have not been granted those study permits. A lot of them want to travel to Canada for a variety of reasons. Like, it doesn't really make a lot of sense spending that much in your tuition fees and not being able to, stay here, be in Canada and have the exposure and all that. So good news. And this also sort of indicates that things are moving towards, if not normal, they're coming close to that, to the normalcy. Immigration is coming up with policies where it seems that in few months time, probably starting of 2021, we will see a lot of different streams resuming, a lot of operations resuming. So this, in terms of travel, the international students being allowed to travel is like probably the first drop of the rain, where in coming months we will most likely see other travel restrictions being taken away as well. So good news for students and good news for other people as well. That's all that I wanted to update. Once we have more updates in terms of what are the details for this, we'll definitely try and update you on that. Enjoy your weekend. wherever in the world you are, take very good care of yourself and your family. Till the next time that we meet through a video. Bye-bye.